So, dalawa. Okay. Okay. So, ang dalawang type ng electrical components, no? Kunin ko muna yung ano ko dito, virtual pen, no? So, dalawa. First, we have the passive, no? Passive component, no? When we say passive component, so these are component that does not, no? Does not utilizes current, no? So hindi niya ginagamit yung current na nasa circuit. So those are passive component. Tapos yung isa naman is active component, no? So the active component is the opposite of passive component. So ang nangyari is the active component utilizes the current, no, in the circuit, no. An example of a passive component, no, example nito, example of a passive component is the switch, no. The switch does not utilizes the current, no, sa ating circuit, no, kasi hindi ang ginagawa lang ng switch is kanyang kinakat lang yung ano, yung passage ng ating current para we can control the circuit, no, kung kapag pwede natin siyang i-on or i-off, no. Yun yung purpose ng switch. An example naman ng active component, no, so na magiging focus sa ating discussion ngayon, so tatlo sila. Una is a resistor, then we have the inductor, and last one is the capacitor, no? So ito yung tatlo na pag-uusapan natin. So these are the three main electrical components, no? Aside from being the three main electrical components, so these three also are somewhat the ano, the basic, no? Basic electronic component, no? So ito makikita din to sa mga electronic circuit or yung mga PCB. So nakikita din yung mga resistor, inductor at kapasitor, no? Okay? So unahin natin yung ano, yung resistor, no? So resistor. So as you can see, ito yung symbol ng resistor. So this are the resistor symbol for the ANSI. So yung ANSI is this, that is applicable in countries na US and Japan and also sa Philippines, kasi sa Philippine Electrical Code ina-adapt natin yung ano, yung ANSI na standard, no? So ito yung kadalasan nakikita natin when we are going to draw resistor sa schematic diagram. So ito, kapag variable naman, when we say variable, pwede natin baguhin yung value ng resistance. So ito yung symbol niya, pwede ito, pwede din ito. So ito yung tatawag natin na ano, na rheostat, ito naman yung potentiometer. So itong dalawa na symbol. But if we are going to have the IEC standard, the IEC standard symbol, no, the IEC stands for International Electrotechnical Commission, no, which is based in Europe. Ito yung kanyang ano, symbol, no? So ito yung kanyang symbol for resistor. So parang katumbas nito yung symbol ng fluorescent lamp, no, na kadalasang ginagamit natin when we are going to have an schematic diagram for a fluorescent lamp. Ang kulang lang is mayroong bilog dito, no? So but for the variable resistor, so parang katulad lang, mayroon siyang arrow, no? Either it is a slant arrow or a downward arrow, no? So in case if makakita kayo ng ganito na type ng ano, ng symbol na resistor, so yan ang ginagamit sa IEC, no, the International Electrotechnical Commission, no? Okay, so a resistor is a two-terminal electrical or electronic component that resists, no? So kanyang ginagawa is resist. So, anong sabihin ng resist? Pinipigilan, no? resist an electric current by producing a voltage drop between its terminal in accordance with Ohm's law. So kaya yung kadalasang ginagawa natin when we are solving DC circuit, no, series parallel na mga resistor, no? So talagang meron tayong voltage drop dito, kunyari series circuit. Okay? So dali ang ano lang diagram, no? So ito yung R1 natin, ito yung R2. So meron talaga tayong voltage drop dito, which is V2, tapos dito naman meron tayong voltage drop na V1, tapos may current na I. Si series to. So yung buong ano niya, yung buong circuit, yung buong current sa buong circuit na to is constant, no? So in accordance with Ohm's law, para makuha natin tong voltage drop kunyari dito sa R2, so yung V2 natin equal yan sa I. So kunyari dito nasa ano tayo, R2. So I2 times R2. So it is in accordance with Ohm's law. So itong V2, ito yung tatawag natin na voltage drop. Then the applications, no? The usual application for a resistor is used to create a voltage current ratio in an electric circuit. So yan yung kanyang pinaka purpose, no? Voltage to current ratio, or in other words, pwede natin siyang gamitin as current limiting, no? Pwede din when we have a DC motor to regulate the speed of a DC motor. So pwede tayong mag-series ng resistor sa ating DC motor. So either that resistor is a fixed resistor or a variable resistor, no? Tapos pwede siyang gamitin as attenuator, no? So yung voltage divider to reduce the voltage of a signal, no? So kadalasan ito ginagamit sa ano, sa mga receiver and transmitter circuit. Pwede din siyang line terminator, which is usually used, no? So aside from electronic circuit, ito yung tinatawag nilang ano, chain bus, no? Ang resistor is ginagamit as line terminator pagdating sa FACP, no? That is the fire alarm control panel, no? So when pag meron tayong mga nakaparallel na bell, yung pinaka last na line, ang ginagawa natin doon is meron tayong siniseries doon sa mismong circuit ng FACP. Ang ginagawa natin is meron din tayong nilalagay na line terminator. The purpose of that is to regulate the current sa ating buong FACP circuit. Then all resistor, so lahat ng resistor, this is either that resistor is fixed, variable, power resistor, electric resistor, sila ay naglalabas ng heat, no? So that is constant to all type of resistor, no? So nakadepende lang yan sa material na ginagamit ng resistor, kung ano yung value ng heat na kaniyang nilalabas. So there are resistor na talagang ginagawa para mag-dissipate ng heat, ng init. At yun ang kadalasang ginagamit natin sa mga electric heater, no? But meron namang mga resistor in the purpose, especially pag series resistor siya sa mga DC motor, ang ginagamit na material is yung material na hindi masyadong naglalabas ng heat, no? Because kapag yung ating mismong series resistor ng ating DC motor is mas mainit pa siya kaysa ating DC motor, so maaring mag-cause yan yung ating mismong DC motor ay mag-overheat, no? So depending on the application, pero ang lahat ng resistor is nag-dissipate or naglalabas ng heat, no? Then we have types of resistor. So una yung fixed resistor. Pag sinabing fixed, hindi na natin mababago yung kanyang resistance, no? So kadalasan they are cylindrical, no? Pinaka-common na resistor na nakikita natin. So they could be carbon film, no? So carbon film or metal film resistor. Yun yung kanyang ano, kanyang material na ginagamit, no? So power resistors come in larger packages. It comes on larger packages, no, which is designed to dissipate heat effectively, efficiently. So ibig sabihin noon, mas maliit yung kanyang nilalabas na heat, because usually power resistor are used for high voltage applications, no? So the high power levels, so resistor to be tend to be wire wound, no? So yung nagamit is wires na. Then resistor used in computers and other devices are typically much smaller, often in surface mount packages without wire leads. So wala siyang ano, wire leads kapag sa computer na mga circuit. Kasi kadalasan naman yung sa computer na circuit, sometimes we call that one as printed PCB. So naka-print yung PCB. So para ang ginagawa doon is printed siya to have an efficient, no? Transfer of signal, no, from electronic circuit to another. Okay. So ito yung mga ano, mga mukha ng fixed resistor. So ito, itong dalawang malaki ito, they are considered as the power resistor. Itong tatlo pala, no? Tatlo, they are considered as power resistor. Habang ito naman, at ito, no? So ito, pinaka-common na nakikita sa mga old radio na mga circuit. So ito yung pinaka-common na electronic resistor. Habang ito naman is kadalasang ginagawa sa mga precision electronic circuit, especially sa mga ano, sa mga multi-tester, itong blue, no? So these are precision na mga na mga resistor, kasi they are small sizes, but yung kanilang tolerance, no, yung ibig sabihin ng tolerance is yung pagbabago-bago ng kanilang value, no, even if they are fixed, so meron siyang tinatawag na tolerance. So itong blue is mas mababa yung kanyang percent ng kanyang tolerance, so compared to this one. Then we have variable resistor. So this resistor are yung value niya is pwede nating ma-adjust, no, by turning a shaft or sliding a control. So they are also called as potentiometer or rheostat, and allow the resistance of the device to be altered by hand. So pwede natin siyang baguhin using our hands, no? Yun yung ano, yun yung sa ano, sa potentiometer at sa rheostat. Ang rheostat is a variable resistor with two terminals, no? Syempre may dalawang terminals 'yan. So one fixed and one sliding, no? And it is used for high current applications. So ang rheostat is for high current. The potentiometer is a common type of variable resistor which is commonly used for volume control for audio amplifiers and other form of amplifiers. Usually the potentiometer is used for low current application, kadalasan sa mga electronics. When we are going to have a variable resistor to control the speed of our motors or the speed of our generators, so ang ginagamit natin is a rheostat, because ang rheostat is para sa mga high current applications. Okay. Then you have the metal oxide varistor or the MOV. So it is a special type of resistor that changes its resistance with the rise in voltage, no? So a very high resistance at low voltage below the trigger voltage, and a very low resistance at a high voltage. So ang pinaka-purpose ng metal oxide varistor is it acts as a switch, no? Kasi pwede kasi natin siyang iset at a certain temperature. Pag tumaas yung temperature, so ang mangyayari is ang kanyang resistance is mababa, no? So it is usually used for short circuit protection in power strips or in lightning bolt arrestor and or snubber in inductive circuit, no? The very common use of metal oxide varistor is the lightning arrestor. So meron tayo yung type ng lightning arrestor na tinatawag natin na metal oxide varistor lightning arrestor. So yung pinaka-common niya na use, no? Then we have here the next one, thermistor. So from the word itself, So a thermistor is a temperature dependent resistor. So ibig sabihin nun, yung kanyang resistance depend on the temperature. So may dalawang klase yan, may the positive and the negative temperature coefficient. So if that is a PTC resistor, that is positive temperature coefficient, so a resistor with a positive temperature coefficient, so when the temperature rises, the resistance of the thermistor will also increase, no? Kapag tumaas yung kaniyang temperature, tataas din yung resistance. Ang negative, so ang mangyari pag negative, if the temperature rises, the resistance drops, so baliktad. So kapag positive temperature coefficient na resistor, so kapag tumaas yung temperature, tataas din yung resistance. Pag negative temperature coefficient, kapag tumaas yung temperature, bababa yung resistance, no? So ang gamit ng ating ng NTC is used for temperature detectors and measuring instrument, no? Okay. Tapos we have the sensistor, is a semiconductor based resistor. Okay, with negative temperature coefficient, usually compensating for the temperature induced effects in electronics, no? So ito yung kadalasang ginagamit to compensate, no, yung heat na nilalabas ng ating mga electronic component, no. Okay, next we have the naming or the getting the value of our resistor, no. So paano natin kinukuha yung value nating resistor? By just looking at the resistor itself. So we have a 4-band axial resistor, no? So una is yung may apat na color band, no? So when we have a resistor, kunyari ito yung resistor natin. Okay. So meron yang apat na color band. So isa, dalawa, tatlo, tapos apat. Minsan din tatlo lang kasi itong apat is considered as no color. Now, the 4-band identification is the most commonly used for color coding scheme on all resistor. No, it consists four colored bands that are painted around the body of the resistor. No, the scheme is simple. The first two numbers are the first two significant digits of the resistance value. The third is the multiplier and the fourth is the tolerance. So ang pagbabasa natin is galing dito sa side na to. So if you are facing the screen, so this will be your left side, no? Papunta dito sa ating right side, no? So kunyari ito ay red, blue, tapos green, tapos yung isa is silver. So yung first na color, it represents the first significant digit, no? Una na digit ng ating value. Yung blue naman is the second significant digit, no? Yung pangalawang digit, habang yung third is the multiplier. At yung last is the fourth one is the tolerance, no? Tolerance. Okay. So, ang tanong ngayon is ano yung value kapag red, blue, ano yung multiplier kapag ito, no? So, kunyari ito brown. So, ano yung multiplier? So, meron tayong chart niyan. Yan. Okay. So the 4-band axial resistor, so we have the color coding, no? So the value for black is 0, no? So pag second or first or second band siya, yung kanyang value is 0, habang pag multiplier siya, that is 10 to the power of 0. Yung 10 to the power of 0, so 10 to the power 0 is just equal to 1, no? Equal to 1. Wala siyang tolerance, no, kapag nasa fourth band. Habang yung brown, that is equal to 1, no? At yung multiplier niya pag siya ay napunta sa third band, so that is times 10 to the power of 1 or equal to 10. Ang red naman ay 2, ang multiplier niya is 100, that is 10 to the power of 2. Yung orange, that is 10 to the power of 3 or equal to 1000. pero 3 yung value niya. So ipapansin nyo, if ano yung kanyang value sa first and second digit, yan din yung exponent dito sa 10 to the power of the exponent. So kunyari ito 4 yung yellow. So 10 to the power of 4 ang kanyang multiplier. So that is equal to 10,000. Habang ito naman yung green, this is equal to 100,000, no? Tapos pag sa blue, so 10 to the power of 6 kasi yung kanyang value is 6. So this is equal to 1 million. Yung violet naman is this is 10, no? 10 million. Kulang ako ng sa 0. Yung 8 is equal to 100, no? 100 million. Tapos yung white, so 9. So kanyang multiplier is equal to 1 billion, no? Yung gold, so that is, yung gold wala siyang value kasi kadalasan yung gold is hindi siya napupunta sa first and second band. Pero ang kanyang multiplier is 0.01. Sa silver is 0.01, yung sa gold para is 0.1, no? So yung na naman, or sabihin nun, no color, so wala siyang multiplier. Pero meron siyang tolerance. So we have for the gold, 5%, for silver, 10%, and for no color, 20%, no? Okay? So, ang problema ngayon is how we are going to familiarize or i-memorize natin to, no? So, meron tayong tawag na mnemonics, no? Kung paano natin madaling maalala yung ating, ano, yung ating color coding, no? So, ang mnemonics niyan, no? Sa, siguro may iba sa nito is nakakaalam na ako ng mnemonics dito. So, ang ating tatandaan lang is ang yung ito. So we have bad boys, so bad boys, so para itong isang kwento eh, so rape our young girls, but Violeta give willingly. Tapos grabe siya do. So yan yung mnemonics na yung talagang ginagamit ko, no? So yung nag-aaral ako ng ano ng engineering, so ito talaga yung mnemonics na lagi ko natandaan kasi una medyo siya may story siya, tapos medyo catchy at nakakatawa yung story, no? So if alam niyo yung mnemonics na to, dapat alam niyo din kung ano ibig sabihin ng bawat words, no? Bad boys rape our young girls, but Violeta give willingly, grabe siya, no? So ano yung meaning ng bawat words na yan? So kunyari bad, so yung bad ang unang letter niya is B, so yung B that is black, so that is the first color sa ating color band na ano natin na chart, black. Tapos yung boys, so yung second na B, which is brown. Yung rape, so the first letter is R, so kaya tawag ang first ko, ang color natin yan is red. Habang itong O naman, no, O or our, so O, so this will be orange. Ito namang yang, so yellow, Y, so dito is yellow. Yung girls, so G, so ito green. Habang yung bat, so B, so isa na lang color na may, na yung first letter niya is B, which is blue. Yung violeta, so V, this is automatic violet. Habang yung G, so give, so G, so may isang color pa na G, that will be gray. Yung W for willingly, no, so ito white. Tapos itong tatlo na tatila, this is for the tolerance. So meron tayong G for grabby, that will be gold. Then yung siya, so S, this will be silver. Yung no, that is N, so that will be none. So yan yung color, yung paano gamitin yung mnemonic. So ang gawin nyo lang is lagyan nyo lang ng values. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, no? Kasi yung black, ang umpisa na number natin for this one is 0 kasi yung value ng black is 0. So yung blue 6, this will be 7, 8, 9. So hanggang 9 lang. Tapos yung gold, this is 5%, 5%, then we have 10% at 20%, no? I-check ko muna yung tolerance. Okay, tama, no? Tolerance. So, yan yung kung paano nyo makabisado itong chart na to, no? By using the mnemonics na bad boys rape our young girls, but Violeta give willingly, no? Okay. So, bago tayo pumunta sa, ano, 5 band, no? So, try muna natin ang, ano, example, no? Okay. So, kunyari, meron tayong resistor na ang kanyang kulay. So, ang kanyang kulay is, the first color is blue. Tapos, yung second is red. Tapos, brown yung kanyang third band, no? Tapos yung fourth is none. So ano yung value ng ating resistance, no? So blue. So if you are going to use our mnemonics, no? Bad boys rape our young girls but will they give willingly. So balik tayo dito. So blue is 6, no? So yung first natin na number for our resistor is 6, no? Then yung second number or the second value of the resistance, no? So this that will be red, no? So that will be 2, no? So 2 yung ating 2 yung ating second value, no? So 2. Then the next one, so ito 2 pala to, no? Brown. So yung third band, that is our multiplier, no? Multiplier natin 'yan. So brown, ano yung multiplier for brown? So that is 1. So that is 10 to the power of 1. So 10 to the power of 1, that is just equal to 10. So times 10. Yung none, so yung none is for the tolerance. So ano yung tolerance natin dito for none? So that is 20%. So yung tolerance niya is plus and minus 20%. So ito 62. So 6 and 2, that will be 62 times 10. So 620 plus and minus 20%. So ohms. So yan yung value ng ating resistance, no? Okay. So for the next na example, so kayo yung magsagot. So yung sagot is ilagay nyo lang sa ano, sa chat box, no? So yung colors are red, green, black, tapos yung fourth niya is gold, no? So siguro 2 minutes, no? 2 minutes para i-chat niyo sa ating ano, chat box na Google Meet chat box yung sagot, no? So red, green, black at gold, no? So yung bad boys rape our young girls, no? So saan ba 'yon? Wala yung ano, mnemonics. So ito, no? So yung first color is red. So ano yung red? So bad boys rape. So that will be 012, no? So yun yung gamit ng ating mnemonics, no? Thank you. Okay, so sa mga ano, may sagot na, so ilagay niyo lang sa chat box, no, yung sagot niyo. So walang problema if your answer is wrong, no, kasi mas okay yung mag-try kayo na sumagot, no, para malaman niyo rin kung ano yung tama, no. So hindi lang yung ano lang nood lang kayo tapos hindi kayo mag-participate, so you will not be able to practice, no. Hindi niya mapapractice kung ano yung ating dinidiscuss dito, no. Lalo na pag nasa ano tayo, practice test na tayo, no, sa ating practice test. Kasi ang sa ating practice test dapat talaga you try to participate, no, para ano, para maalam nyo din kung paano sagutin yung mga problems. Okay, so as of now, isa pa lang yung ano nag-chat sa chat box, no. Okay, siguro we will try to answer this one para hindi naman tayo mag-aksaya ng oras, no. Okay, so the first one is red, no, red. So red, that will be 2, no, 2. So ito, sabi yun, ito. So this will be 2. Habang yung green, so yung green, that is 5, no? So this will be 5. Yung black dito is multiplier. So yung value ng black is 0, no? So mangyayari dito, times 10 to the power of 0, no? So sinabi ko kanina, yung times 10 to the power of 0, balik tayo sa ating chart, that is equal to 1, no? So ito, sabi yun, wala. Yan. Yan. So ito, magiging times 1 lang to. Yung 10 times 10 to the power of 1, magiging times 1 lang yan, no? So yung gold, this is plus and minus 5% na tolerance, no? Okay. So 25 times 1, so that will just be 25 ohms plus and minus 5%. So ito yung tamang sagot, no? So kadalasan talaga nagkakamali tayo sa tolerance, no? So ang atin lang isipin is yung value niya, yan din yung exponent ng ating multiplier, no? So kunyari, 10 to the power of 1, that is equal to 1. 10 to the power of 1, that is equal to 10. 10 to the power of 2, 100. So katulad dito, no? So ito yung mga value ng ating multiplier, no? Okay, so let's proceed with the 5-band axial resistor. So pareho lang yan sa 4-band coding. Kaso yung 5th band, that is the temperature coefficient, o yung value ng pagbabago ng kanyang resistance in accordance with the change in temperature. So dito makikita sa ating chart ito, the temperature coefficient. So we have 1 for black, wala, no? For brown, 100, no? 100, that is 100 ppm or parts per million. Yung ibig sabihin ng ppm, parts per million. So ibig sabihin yan, sa 1 million, mayroong 100 parts doon na value niya, or mayroong 100 na value na. Habang for red, that is 50 ppm, 15 ppm for orange, 25 ppm for yellow. So wala tayo sa green. Tapos wala din sa ibang colors, no? Wala sa ibang colors. So ang atin lang kailangan i-memorize is brown, red, orange, and yellow. So for brown, 100, for red, 50, for orange, 15, and for yellow, 25, no? So ito lang yung mahalaga if the resistor is a 5-band resistor, no? Okay. So next, we will go to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So sa part na to is we will be going to an inductor, no? So inductor na tayo na component. So according to Faraday's law, so si Michael Faraday, as a scientist and as a physicist, no, he developed the theory of electromagnetic induction. Sinabi niya that the first law of electromagnetic induction, that whenever a flux linking a coil or current changes an EMF is induced in it, no? So if a coil, no, is passed through a is changing, no, yung kahit sa change niya, meron tayong na-generate na EMF or electromotive force, or the other term for that is voltage, no. The second law is the magnitude, so yung ano, yung value ng ating induced EMF is proportional sa rate of change. Ano yung rate of change? Kung ano yung value ng pagbabago ng ating current or ng ating flux. Yung flux is the magnetic lines, no? Magnetic lines. Okay. Because sa law ng electromagnetic induction, yung electricity will create magnetism. In case if we are going to disrupt, so ginawa natin is ginalaw natin yung flux, yung wire na gumalaw sa flux, mag-i-induce siya ng voltage. So that is the first law. Tapos yung second law, ang value ng voltage na nasa wire na yon is nakadepende if gano'n natin kabilis, no? Gano'n natin kabilis binabago yung flux or ano yung rate or the speed of the wire na gumagalaw or tumatawid sa ating magnetic lines or sa ating flux, no? So aside from the inductor, the electromagnetic induction is applicable sa generator, motors, and transformers. So but for this discussion lang, ipo-focus natin siya muna sa inductor, no? So ito yung voltage na nasa inductor. So the voltage in an inductor is equal to L. Yung L natin, that is our inductance, no? Tapos yung I is the current, tapos yung T is time. So for T, dapat yung time natin is naka seconds, no? Habang yung current naman, so of course the unit for current is amperes. For self-inductance, the unit for this one is Henry, no? Henry yung unit ng self inductance. Okay. So the inductor. So there are two fundamental principles of electromagnetics, no? So ito yung nasa loob ng susunod ng inductor. So moving electrons create a magnetic field. Then moving or changing magnetic field cause electrons to move, no? An inductor is a coil of wire through which electrons move and energy is stored in a resulting magnetic field, no? So ang inductor pala, coil, no? Coil of wire na kung saan yung electron natin is gumagalaw, tapos yung energy, no? Energy is stored sa nabubuo na magnetic field sa ating inductor. Okay. So ito yung ano, principle ng inductor. So ito yung inductor natin. Then we have create a magnetic field kasi meron tayong electron na nag-flow sa ating coil. So yung energy na nadala ng ating electron is nasustore siya sa magnetic field na nag-create naman dahil sa pag-flow ng ating electron, no? So like capacitors, so inductors temporarily store energy. But unlike capacitors, inductors store energy sa magnetic field, hindi sa electric field. So mamaya yung capacitor sa electric field niya in-store yung energy. So when the source is removed, the magnetic field collapses immediately. So kapag tinanggal natin yung supply, yung ating energy na na-store sa ating magnetic field is nawawala din kasi instantly din nawawala yung ating magnetic field na kung saan doon naka-store ang energy na galing sa ating electrons. Okay. So, inductors are simply coil of wire na pwede airborne, no? So, yung gitna niya is air. Pwede din gamit yung permeable material, no? Mecha or whatsoever na material. Pwede din siya toroidal form or circular form ito. Okay. So the unit for inductance inductor, no, is Henry. So a Henry is a measure of the intensity of the magnetic field that is produced, no. So the typical values of Henry in electronics is millihenry or microhenry. kapag sa mga ano naman sa mga electrical circuits naman, so kadalasan nasa milihenry or henry itself yung kanyang value. Okay, so the amount of inductance in the inductor is influence. So ano yung nag-i-influence sa value ng inductance sa ating inductor? So ano yan? Ito yung nag-i-influence. The number of coil turns. Ilan yung ano, yung turns natin sa ating inductor. The diameter of a coil or yung laki ng ating wire na ginagamit natin as coil. Spacing, no? Spacing between the turns. Then we have size of wire used, tapos type of material inside the coil, no? Okay. So yung inductor kapag kinonek natin siya sa DC current, no? Yung supply natin is DC. So the inductor, the increasing magnetic field opposes the current flow and the current flow is minimum. So ang ginagawa ng ating ano, ng ating inductor kapag DC is nari in, ang ginagawa niya is regulates the current, no? So kapag nasa maximum na yung current, so ang nangyayari diyan is yung flow of current is maintained by the magnetic field. So as soon as the current source is removed or the source is removed, so yung ano, yung inductor natin is yung inductor natin, the magnetic field collapse and create a high inrush current, no? In the other direction. So parang nagdi-discharge siya ng current sa ng large amount of current na mabilisan, no? So yan yung nangyayari kapag DC yung kinonek natin sa ating inductor. Kapag AC naman, no, which will be also discussed pagdating natin sa ating AC circuit, no. Kapag AC, so nagkakaroon lang yan ng tinatawag nating inductive, no. So inductive reactance, which is the same as a resistance na nag-o-oppose sa flow ng current, thereby creating a so-called lagging power factor, no? Yung ating power factor is bumababa kapag yung inductor natin is connected in an AC supply. Okay. So we have the different types of inductor. We have the ferromagnetic or ion core inductors. So yung kanyang ano, yung kanyang core, no? Nasa gitna niya is iron. So kaya tawag siyang ferromagnetic core or ion core inductors. Variable inductors, so the same with variable resistor, so nababago-bago ang kanyang value ng kanyang inductance. So these are usually used in getting the resonant frequency of signal circuits, no? So yan yung pinaka-purpose ng variable inductor. So choke is usually used in AC circuit, no, to allow the DC circuit or the DC signal to pass at lower frequencies, no. Okay, so meron naman tayong series connected inductors, no. Kapag yung inductor natin is connected in series, the total inductance is just equal to the sum of the individual inductors. Kapag parallel naman, so katulad lang sa ano, sa parallel parallel resistor, no? So equal siya sa reciprocal ng bawat nakaparallel na inductor. Okay. So meron naman tayong the inductance if the series coil has we will considering the mutual inductance, so yung inductance that exists, no, kapag nakalapit yung dalawang inductor, nakikreate din sila ng magnetic field. Nangyari kasi yung kanilang magnetic field, no? Kunyari, ito yung dalawang inductor natin. So, kikreate yan ng magnetic field. Ito rin kikreate. Ang nangyayari kasi is yung dalawang magnetic field nila is nagpang-abot, no? So, yan tinatawag ito yung mutual inductance. So, if they are series leading, ibig sabihin nun, they are aligned in the same polarity, no? So, pareho yung kanilang polarity. So, ito yung formula, series leading. Kapag hindi naman, no, kapag magkabilaan ang kanilang polarity katulad dito, so that is series opposing at ito yung kanyang formula, no, L1 plus L1 plus L2 minus 2M. Yung M naman, siguro hindi klaro, no? Kasi nakaano siya. Naka-black yung kulay. Sibahin ko lang yung kulay. Yan. So, yung M naman is for the mutual inductance. So, ito yung formula niya, no? But usually sa problem is given yung mutual inductance, kumukuha lang yung total value ng inductance if they are series opposing and series leading. So ito lang yung formula na mahalaga, ito, tapos for series leading naman ay ito, no? Okay, so for parallel na ano na inductor in which we are considering the mutual inductance, so ito yung formula, no? So, ang pagkakaiba lang is sa series aiding, ito minus, no? Yung sa baba, minus. Pag series opposing naman, ito ay plus, no? Okay? So, if ever you need a copy ng formula, so aside kasi ng ano, recorded video nito, so ipopost ko din sa ating website yung ano, yung PDF copy nito, no? Nung lahat ng ano, ng slides ng ating discussion, no? Para you can also familiarize with the formula. Okay, next. The energy stored in an inductor. So, ito yung formula. So, W, this is the energy. No? Habang yung L is the inductance, tapos yung I is the current. So, W is equals to 1/2 L I squared. No? So, the unit for energy is joule. Okay, so ang capacitor. So, this is our capacitor. This is our battery. So, the purpose of the capacitor is to store the energy in the electric field. No? The capacitance is the measure. No? So, yung measure on how well the capacitor can store energy. So, for capacitance, ito yung formula. Capacitance is equal to charge over the voltage, no? Or the volts. No? Then, so a capacitor is a device, no? Tulad sinabi ko niya, when it comes to capacitor, it stores in its energy, the energy in an electric field. So, yun yung capacitor. Pag inductor naman, magnetic field, no? So it is made up of two conductive plates separated by a non-conductive material, no? The electrons accumulate on one plate, forcing electron away from the other plate, leaving a net positive charge. So nagkakaroon siya ng ano, ng charge, no? So ang pinaka ano, pinaka common sa pinaka picture natin sa capacitor is a temporary storage battery, no? Temporary. So kasi temporary siya, kasi once we are kapag na-disconnect niya yung source, so nag-discharge sa agad, no? So yan yung anong capacitor natin. Then the capacitor physical construction, so they are rated. So ano yung makikita natin sa ating capacitor rating? So the amount of charge that can be held. So ito yung ano, naka-farad, no? Kasi yun yung value ng ng capacitance. The voltage handling capabilities, ano yung maximum na kaya i-handle natin capacitor before siya magiging masasabog or magano yung loob niya is ma-short. Tapos yung insulating material, ano yung material na sa gitna? Yeah, is it a ceramic or a electrolytic, no? So yan yung mga kadalasang physical construction ng capacitor. Okay. So the capacitor's ability to hold a charge will depend, no, sa mga factors na to: the conductive plate surface area, yung area ng ating conductive plate, the space between dito. Okay, so syempre kung mas malapit, so mas strong yung electric field, mas tataas yung kanyang capacitance. And the material between the plates, kung ano yung material na sa gitna. So sometimes it is air, sometimes mecha, sometimes electrolytic, no? Then types of capacitor. So this is according to the materials used, yung electrolytic capacitor, which is the very common capacitor used in electronic circuits, no? So they are used in very high capacitance, no? Pero mas medyo ano naman, medyo disadvantage nila is yung kanilang tolerance is poor, meaning mas madaling mabago-bago ang kanilang value ng kanilang ano capacitance. For film capacitors, so they are plastic, no? Plastic film or polymer film. So they are usually used on AC applications, no? Then you have the ceramic capacitor, the very common, no? Which is fixed value capacitor, no? Aside from electrolytic, ito yung kasi nakikita natin, no? Na color brown na capacitor na parang bilog, no? Ito yung itsura niya. So, ganyan, bilog tapos may dalawang ganyan. So, the ceramic capacitor, no, is non-polarized. Anong ibig sabihin ng non-polarized? So, wala siyang positive or negative terminal. Unlike the other capacitor, especially the electrolytic capacitor, which is usually used in motors, in sa mga aircon, electrolytic yan. So, meron siyang positive-negative na terminal. Kapag nabaliktad mo, it will cause the capacitor to short circuit. No? So, yung ating ceramic capacitor, wala yang ano. It is non-polarized. So, wala siyang positive-negative terminal. Pwede mo siya baliktarin. Then, it has two application classes. No? Class 1 ng ating ceramic capacitor is for high stability, tapos low losses. Yung isa naman is high volumetric efficiency of buffer, bypass, and coupling applications. So, ang behavior ng ating ano capacitor in DC current, so ang ginagawa niya is blocks the DC current, no, passing through the circuit once the capacitor is fully charged, no. Sa AC naman, so it will create a capacitive, no, capacitive reactance. So what we do mean by capacitive reactance? So ito yung reactance na nag-i-increase, no, nag-i-increase sa ating power factor, no. Atin naman i-discuss in detail next week, no? Kasi yung next topic natin, AC circuits. Okay, so ito yung kadalasang value ng ating capacitor, no? So, bihira tayong makita ng capacitor na farad talaga niyang kanyang value. Kadalasan, naka-microfarad yan. Ito yung symbol, tapos may F dyan. Nanofarad, N yung symbol, tapos may F. Picofarad, P yung symbol, tapos may F, no? So, medyo maliit lang yung value ng ating capacitance, no? Kasi pag lumaki yung ating capacitance, lalaki din yung ating capacitor. Kasi as we all know, the capacitance depends on the surface area of our capacitor. So kaya if we have a 1 farad capacitor, so sobrang laki noon compared yung kadalasan natin nakikita sa ating electronic circuit, which is in micro, no? Pati yung nakikita natin sa mga aircon, it's still that is in micro. So that is 0.5 na 0 before mag 1. So ganun kaliit yung value nun. So imagine if you have a 1 farad capacitor. So yung 1 farad capacitor, kadalasan yan yung nakikita natin sa mga substation to increase the power factor of our system, no? So in motor applications, no, yung capacitor na ginagamit natin sa ating mga fan, electric fan natin, sa ating ano, sa ating mga drills, so kadalasan those are in microfarad kasi maliliit lang, no. Sa electronics, still microfarad, may iba nga picofarad, pati yung sa ating mga cellphone may capacitor yan, so that is nano and picofarad ng mga value kasi mas maliit, no. Next, we have ito yung ano, giving the value of the capacitor if that is a ceramic capacitor. So, mention tolerance. So, then, yung classification niya Z, no? Okay? So, capacitor in circuits, no? So, kapag yung capacitor is connected in series, so, yung capacitor connected in series para siyang resistor connected in parallel. No? So, ang ginagawa natin is we are getting the inverse, yung total ng inverse, tapos i-inverse natin yun yung total capacitance. No? So, kapag capacitor is connected in series, constant yung charge. No? Constant yung charge na nag-flow sa ating circuit. Tapos, yung ating value ng ating value ng ating voltage na sa bawat capacitor equal yan siya sa voltage source, no? If we go going back to series resistor, so dito if ito yung mga resistor, ang constant dito is the current, no? And also for the series inductor, current yung constant. But series capacitor, ang constant is the charge. Sa parallel capacitor naman, so constant yung ating voltage, tapos yung bawat charge ng ating capacitor, kapag kinuha natin yung total niyan, yan yung ating total charge. Yung total capacitance naman para siyang total lang ng ano, total ng bawat capacitor, no? D. So mangyari kasi yung parallel connected capacitor, we will interpret that one katulad ng series connected resistor, no? So kapag kunin natin yung kanyang capacitance, total capacitance, ia-add lang natin yung value ng bawat capacitor. Kapag series connected capacitor naman, parang series resistor. Kaya mayroon tayong total ng inverse, tapos i-inverse pa natin. Okay. Then the energy stored in a capacitor, so this is equal to 1/2 CE squared, no? So yung kanina, yung sa inductor, formula ng inductor is 1/2 LI squared. So sa inductor, current, sa capacitor, voltage. Sa inductor, inductance, sa capacitor, capacitance, no? Okay? So we will go now to the practice test, no? So let's have the first problem. How much inductance of the coil that is induced when the current changes at the rate of 5 milliamperes in 2 microseconds, no? So hinahanap natin is inductance ng ating coil, no? So para ano naman, para magkaroon tayo ng konting idea on how to solve this one, so we'll look up the formula, no? So balik natin yung formula dito. Yan, ito yung formula na gagamitin nyo. Okay, so that is E is equal to LI over T, no? Okay. So yung formula na gagamitin nyo is the voltage is equal to the inductance times the current times the over the time, no? So yung time natin naka-seconds. Okay, so ang kukunin nyo is the inductance. Okay, so your 2 minutes starts, no? So meron na tayong 1 minute and 30 seconds. So if may sagot kayo, just write the letter of your answer on our chat box. So yung given natin, so meron tayong inductor na ang kanyang voltage is 500 volts, no? So meron tayong E equal to 500 volts. Yung kanyang amperes or current, so that is equal to 5 milli, no? So 5 milli. The current is equal to 5 milliamperes. So, ano yung value ng milli? So, milli is times 10 to the power of negative 3. So, 5 milli, so times 10 to the power of negative 3 amperes. So, ganyan yung, ano nyo, yung pagkasulat nyo ng given. When we are using SI prefixes like milli. So, ito siya. Yan. Ang last is T, which is equal to yung value ng time. That is 2 microseconds, no? So 2 microseconds. So yung micro, that is 10 to the power of negative 6. So we have 2 times 10 to the power of negative 6 seconds. Yung formula na gagamitin natin, so E is equal to L I over T. So gagawin natin, dapat dito sa side na to, yung L ang yung matira. So ilipat natin yung T dito. So mangyayari diyan is ito na sa baba, mapupunta sa itaas. So L times T is equal to L times I. Itong I naman ililipat natin sa kabila. So ito na sa taas, pagkalipat sa kabila, mapupunta yan sa ibaba. So we have E times T over I is equal to L. So we can now solve our L using this formula. So L is equal to E. So ano yung E natin? 500 volts. Yung T natin is 2 times 10 to the power of negative 6. So yan yung time, no? Seconds. Over yung current natin is 5 times 10 to the power of negative 3 amperes, no? Okay. So now using our calculator. Okay? So input natin yung ano mga numbers, so 500. Okay, so I hope klaro yung ano, klaro lang pala yung ano, yung ating calculator, no? 500 then 2. So ito yung times 10 to the power of negative 6, no? Tapos sa baba naman tayo, so 5 times 10 to the power of negative 3. So this is equal to, so 1/5. So i-tick nyo yung SD, itong SD, para maging decimal siya. So 0.2, no? So sa mga sumagot ng 0.2, so you got the correct answer, 0.2 Henry. In case if your calculator is not like this one, no? Yung wala siyang natural display. So gawin nyo lang is 500. So gamitin nyo lang yung mga parentheses, no? Tapos 2xp. So kadalasan kasi itong times to the power of negative 6, this is exp, no? So sa ano, keypad ng mga calculator na hindi siya naka-natural display, divide parenthesis 5 exp tapos negative 3 tapos close parenthesis equals. Okay, so 0.2. so ang tamang sagot is 0.2. Sabi yun. Okay, saan ka? Ito. So, letter B yung tamang sagot, no? So, congrats doon sa mga nakakuha ng tamang sagot, no? Okay? Next question. Varistors are insulators, non-linear resistor, carbon resistor, or resistor with zero temperature coefficient. So varistor. So the other term for varistor is variable resistor, no? So ito kahit hindi 2 minutes kaya natong sagutin. So ano ba yung varistor? Are they insulators, non-linear resistor, carbon resistor, or resistor with zero terminal coefficients? Okay, so siguro 1 minute lang, no? Hindi naman to kailangan i-solve. Okay, so medyo madami-dami yung sumagot, ah. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter B. So, non-linear resistor. So, when we say non-linear resistor, ibig sabihin nun, ang value ng kanilang resistance ay nagbabago depending on the setting or the setting of the knob or kung ano yung kanyang preset na value at that instant. So kaya non-linear kasi kapag ginap natin or gumawa tayo ng graph ng kanyang ano resistance, either pataas yan or pababa. If linear resistor, that is the fixed resistor, ang kanyang graph is fixed, no? Straight line, no? Okay, next. A capacitor stores 0.24 coulomb at 10 volts. Its capacitance is blank. Okay. So to help you na ma-solve yung capacitance, so balikan natin yung formula. Capacitance is equal to charge over the voltage. Okay. So 2 minutes. Okay, so may nagsagot na ng ano, letter A, E. So let's try to answer, no? Okay. So yung given natin, so meron tayong given na charge. So charge, that is Q. Tapos natin given na voltage, ang hanapin natin is the capacitance, no? So yung given natin na charge is 0.24, habang yung voltage naman is 10 volts, no? So the charge is 0.24 coulomb. So ito yung symbol ng coulomb. Yung voltage is 10 volts. Tapos yung capacitance is the required, no? So yung formula, capacitance is equal to charge over the voltage. So we have 0.24 coulomb over 10 volts. So that is 0.24 divide 10, no? Okay, so meron tayong 0.024 farad, no? So ito yung answer, which is letter A, no? Letter A yung ating answer, no? So lan nakakuha 1 2 3 4, no? So 1 2 3 4, so 4 yung nakakuha ng tamang sagot, no? Okay, so congrats. Now next we have ito kailangan i-solve, no? For making a capacitor, it is better to select a dielectric having a low permittivity, a high permittivity same as that of air, or permittivity more than that of air. Now when we say permittivity, ito yung kanyang ano, ang kanyang value na kung saan it allows the flow of electrons, no, sa kanya. So yung ibig sabihin ng permittivity, so if gagawa tayo ng capacitor, ano yung pinaka mainam na ano value ng ating dielectric? Okay, so sa ganito mga ano, 1 minute lang ibibigay natin, no? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter C, no? The purpose for that one is dapat taasan natin yung permittivity is so that we could have a higher capacitance, no? So the permittivity is the ability of a certain material to allow the flow of current. So ibig sabihin nun is pag nakikita natin yung ating permittivity, mas mataas ang kanyang value to sustain, no, to sustain the electric field. So kaya mas mataas yung permittivity. Okay, next. The unit of capacitance are blank. So alin dito yung unit ng capacitance? Okay. So ito madali lang to. If you know the formula on how to solve for the capacitance, alam niyo kung ano yung unit ng capacitance, no, units. So, ibig sabihin, it is a combination of two or more units. So kaya nakikita nyo dito, mayroong over, no? Over coulomb, over volts, over hand, Weber. Itong W, this is Weber. Okay. So, mayroong nagsagot ng B. So, ganito mga problem, 1 minute lang, no? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter B. So, bakit letter B? So, going back to the formula, capacitance is charge over voltage. So, ano yung unit ng charge? The unit of charge is, okay, the unit for charge is coulomb, while the unit for voltage is volts, no? So, coulomb over volts. So, kaya letter B yung ating tamang sagot. Okay? Next, if 3 microfarad capacitors are connected in series, the net capacitance is blank. No? So, ano ang kanyang net capacitance? Okay, naka-ano na pala, naka-highlight na pala. Pero, isasolve pa rin natin ito, no? Kung paano kukunin yung kanyang net capacitance. No? Okay, so the answer for this one, kasi naka-highlight na, is letter A. But how to get this one, the value of net capacitance? No? So, if we are going back to the problem, so, connected in series, no? Series yung kanyang connection. Pero capacitor. So, if this is series capacitor, we will treat the capacitor like a parallel resistor. Okay. So, paano natin isosolve yung parallel resistor? So, kukunin natin yung kanyang total resistance. But for this one, we'll get the total capacitance. Now, this is a special case kasi equal yung value ng mga yung capacitance. So, equal ang value ng capacitor na ating kukunan ng total capacitance or the net capacitance. So, 15, no? Tatlong 15 na microfarad, no? So, sa ganito, ang gagawin lang natin is we get the value, so that is the capacitance of the capacitor. So, yan yung ating C. Tapos, kung ilan siya na i-coconnect in series, no? That is C over N, no? So, itong formula to, this is applicable for capacitor connected in series if equal sila ng capacitor. So, we have 15 microfarad. Yan yung value ng ating capacitor. Ilan sila? Tatlo. So, 15 divide 3. So, the correct answer is 5 microfarad. So, kaya letter A yung ating tamang sagot. Okay? So, sayang, no? Nakalagay na yung correct answer. Next. Okay. If 310 microfarad capacitors are connected in parallel, the net capacitance is blank. So, 2 minutes. So, ito naman, may tatlo na 10 microfarad na capacitor na nakakonect in parallel. So, ito, ano yung kanyang value ng kanyang net capacitance or total capacitance. Okay, so may sumagot na ng B. Bilis ah. No? So, 30 seconds lang. So 20 seconds. Okay, so the correct answer for this one, no? So muna natin bago natin sabihin yung correct answer. Okay, so meron tayong 3 na 10 microfarad capacitor which is connected in parallel. So, if capacitors are connected in parallel, so parang series connected resistor yan, or kukunin na natin yung kanilang total. So, yung ating total capacitance is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. So, yung C1 natin 10 microfarad, C2, 10 microfarad, kasi equal lang sa lahat, no? Tatlong 10, no? Okay, so we have 10 plus 10 plus 10, that will be 30 microfarad. The correct answer is letter B. No? So, madali lang, kapag alam natin yung concept ng series, ng parallel connected capacitor. Okay, next. A dielectric material must be blank. So, ano yung dielectric material? Ano siya? Must be a resistor, insulator, good conductor, or a semiconductor? Okay, so dalawa lang yung ano na chat ng kanilang sagot, no? Okay. So for this problem, so pwede rin sabihin na yung sagot natin is pwede A, pwede B, pwede C, but we need to analyze, no? Kapag yung ating dielectric material is a resistor, so hindi na siya ano magiging dielectric material, it is a purely passive active element resistor, kasi itong dielectric that is capacitor, no, capacitor yung ginagawa natin. Pag insulator naman, so kapag insulator, so there's no way na yung ating electrons is makaka-stay doon sa ating conductive plate. Kapag good conductor naman, it will allow the resistor to pass through the plate, no? So by pass through, if that is a good conductor, so kunyari ito yung ating ano, ito yung ating capacitor, no? Okay, so if it is a conductor, so yung ating electron is agad lang siyang flow, no, from this terminal positive to the negative terminal. So ito, kapag ganito, ano ang tawag dito? Ang tawag dito is short circuit. So how to resolve this dilemma? Dapat yung ating dielectric is between a capacitor and an inductor. An insulator pala, no? Between a conductor and an insulator. At ang tawag doon is a semiconductor. So ito yung dielectric material natin, because a semiconductor has a certain value na kung saan magiging conductor siya at magiging insulator depending on the temperature itself, no? Okay, next. An electric capacitor can be used for blank. Okay. So, para saan yung ating electrolytic capacitor? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter C. So, pwede siya sa DC at AC. Kaya nga, meron tayong electrolytic capacitor sa mga fan at ating aircon. No, electrolytic capacitor yan. Sa DC naman, sa ating mga electronic circuit. No? So, the correct answer is letter C. Okay. Duplicate lang yung next. Nandito. The capacitance of a capacitor is not affected by the blank. So, ang capacitance daw ng capacitor is not affected by the blank. Okay, so let's have the answer, no? So para malaman yung answer, so balikan natin yung slide na nagko-contain kung ano yung mga factors that will affect the value of capacitance, no? So, tingnan natin dito sa taas. Ayan. Okay. Ano ba yun? Okay, so meron tayong the conductive plate. Surface area, the space. So ito kasi yung ano eh, nag-i-effect na, nag-a-affect ng value ng capacitance. So conductive plate, surface area, yung surface area ng ating plate, the space between, yung distance, tapos yung material between the plate, no? So balikan natin yung choices, no? Yan. So ang correct answer for this one, no? So surface area of the plate. So ito, tama to. Nag-a-affecto sa kanyang capacitance. Distance, so that is the spacing. So, affecting ito. Ang wala doon is the thickness. Kasi ang pangatlong factor kasi is the material of the plate. No? So, the correct answer is letter C. Huh? Okay, next. So, two plates of a parallel capacitor after being charged from a constant voltage source are separated apart by means of insulated handles. Then the blank, so the voltage across the plates, the voltage across the plate decreases, charge on the plate decreases, or the charge on the capacitor increases. Okay. Wala ba sa screen? Natin. Okay, parang delay yata konti yung ating ano. Okay. Okay, so okay na. No? So medyo delay ng konti yung ano, yung countdown. Tingnan ko muna dito. Delay nga, no? So dito 26 pa lang. Okay, so okay, ano na lang yung ano, yung answer nyo, no? Chat na lang sa chat box. Okay. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter C, no? The charge on the capacitor decreases kasi unti-unti nang yang nagdi-discharge, no? So parang humabol na yata yung ano, yung connection, no? So unti-unti na siyang nagdi-discharge. Okay. Next. If AC voltage is applied to a capacitive circuit, the alternating current can flow in the circuit because varying voltage produces the charging and discharging current. The high peak of a high peak value, charging current can flow, discharge current can flow. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter A, no? Letter A. So the varying voltage produces charging and discharging current. So kaya nag-a-allow yun to flow, no? Para makapag-flow yung ating current, no? Okay, next. Which of the following statement is correct, no? Air capacitor has a black band to indicate the outside foil. Electrolytic capacitor must be connected in correct polarity. Ceramic capacitor must be connected in correct polarity. Mega capacitors are available in capacity value of 1 to 10 picofarad. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter B, no? Statement is correct, so tama yung letter B. The electrolytic capacitor must be connected in the correct polarity. Sa ceramic, kahit hindi na correct polarity yan kasi it is a non-polarized capacitor, no? Habang yung sa meka naman, so it is not available at lower, no? Lower na capacitance, no? Ito namang about air capacitor, so wala yang color banding, no? Wala yang color band yung ating yung capacitor. Ang may black lang na band is the electrolytic. Okay, next. Yan. Habol ba yung ano? Okay. The dissipation factor of a good dielectric is one of the order of black. So ano yung order ng ating dissipation factor? So these are the type. Ito yung mga type na mga question na medyo kapag mga tawag mga theory questions, no? Yung hindi ka lang ating mag-solve. So this is one of the top nature question, no? Kasi hindi to masyado talagang napagdaanan when it comes to experience or sa school, no? Or during the college years, no? Kasi bihira lang itong i-discuss. No? Pero, we'll have this one kasi minsan ito lumabas yung Q factor, the dissipation factor. Okay, so, para ko sagutin yan, we will discuss the dissipation factor. No? So, dissipation factor, parang huli yata yung screen na naman. Ha? Okay, so the dissipation factor is defined as the reciprocal of the ratio between the insulating material capacitive reactance to its resistance. So, it's measure the inefficiency of an insulating material. So, the lower the dissipation factor, the more efficient is the insulator system. So, kapag mababa yung value ng iyong dissipation factor, mas efficient yung iyong insulator. So, going back sa ating problem, ang pinakamababang na value dito is 0.02. No? Ito yung pinakamaliit na value. So, therefore, the best dissipation factor must be on this order, yung 0.02. So, yung letter A, yung tamang sagot. No? Okay? So, hindi yata gumagalaw na naman yung screen. Okay. Next, no? So, tayo muna natin gumalaw yung screen. Yan. The total electric flux through any closed surface surrounding charges is equal to the amount of charge enclosed. The above statement is associated with black. Okay, so ito din medyo ano dito siya, top nature question, no? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter A, no? So this is Coulomb's square law, no? Next. So this will be our last question, no? Which of the following parameter variation, the capacitance of capacitor remains unaffected, no? So alin dito? Yung hindi nakaka-affect, no? Sa value ng ating capacitor. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter D, no? Letter D, the thickness of the capacitor. Okay? Tingnan natin mayroon pa bang ibang question. Ayan, mayroon pala. Pa. Okay, which of the following statement is true, no? The current in the discharging capacitor grows linearly. The current in a discharging capacitor grows exponentially. The current in a discharging capacitor decays exponentially. Or the current in the discharging capacitor decreases constantly. So, alin dyan yung tama? No? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter C, no? Exponentially. Ibig sabihin nun, habang tumatagal yung time na nag-discharge siya is lumalaki din yung kanyang discharging rate. So, kaya exponentially. Okay, next. Ano pa yata? Okay, so in a capacitor, the electric charge is stored in block. So, saan naka-store yung ating charge. Okay, so the correct answer is between the metal plates. No? So, between the plates. Okay? Next. Meron pa ba? Okay, meron pa. Which of the following material has the highest value of dielectric constant? So, alin dito yung mataas yung value ng kanyang dielectric constant? Okay. So the correct answer for this one, so tingnan mo natin yung chart natin dito, no? So the dielectric constant for vacuum is 1.0, then for porcelain, so that is ceramic, no? So that is 6.5. Then for 6.5, then for glass that is 4.7, no? 4.7. Okay. Okay, 4.7. Tapos for oil, okay, dito yung oil, no? So oil is a liquid, no? So if you can see, itong ethanol, this is a liquid, water is also a liquid. So if a certain material is a liquid, so mas mataas yung kanyang dielectric constant. So the correct answer for this one is letter D, no? Okay. Okay. Ito pala. Next is, which of the following capacitors will have the least variation, no? So yung pagbago-bago ng kanyang value. Okay, so the correct answer is letter C, no? Silver plated mega capacitor. No? The silver itself will make the variation less, no? So medyo mas mababa yung variation because of the silver plating. Because we know silver is a high conductive material, no? Kaya nagiging less yung pagbabago-bago ng kanyang capacitance. Okay, next. When 4 volts EMF is applied across a 1 farad capacitor, it will store energy of Planck. So, ang hinahanap dito is the amount of energy stored, no? If yung ating voltage is 4 volts, tapos yung ating capacitance is 1 farad na capacitor. Okay, so siguro ano na, lumabas na sa screen, no? So medyo delay konti yung ano, upload speed ng internet. No? Siguro medyo delay ngayon kasi Saturday, so marami yung ano, gumagamit ng ano, ng internet. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is, solve natin, no? Okay, so we have the given voltage is 4 volts, tapos yung ating capacitance is 1 farad. So we are going to get the energy, no? So that is 1 half CE squared. So meron tayong 1 half times yung ating kapasitan, 1 farad. Tapos yung ating voltage is 4 volts squared. So we have 1 half times 1 times 4 squared. So that is 16. So we have 1 half times 16. So that will be equal to 8 joule. So yung ating sagot is letter D, which is 8 joules. No? Okay, so next. So the law that induces EMF and current always oppose the producing them is due to, no? So medyo dali lang konti, 49 agad. Okay, so this one, the correct answer for this one, no, yung kanyang direction ng ating current with the EMF producing it is the law of Lenz or the Lenz law. No? So this is all about the principle of electromagnetic induction. No? So if medyo delay, so ano na lang, ibibigay ko na lang kaagad yung ano, sagot. No? Tapos sa mga recorded naman is you can see also the ano, solution. Okay, next we have which of the following is not a unit of inductance. So alin dito yung unit of inductance, hindi unit ng inductance. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter C. No, first and foremost, inductance does not involve charge, so lang hindi kasama yung coulomb. No, so kaya correct answer is letter B. Henry is the unit for inductance. Itong volt second ampere, this is equivalent to Henry. No, equivalent lang yan sa Henry. Kaya ang answer natin is letter B. Hindi, the coulomb per volt ampere is not a unit of inductance. Okay, 24. In case of an inductance, current is proportional to blank. Okay, to the voltage across the inductance, magnetic field, both A and B, or neither A nor B. Okay. So, okay na ba? So, nabalik na ba yung sa screen, no? Tingin ko nabalik na, no? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter A, the voltage across the inductance. Okay, then 25, no? So this will be our last, no? Ito na tayo last kasi wala na yung mga questions baba. Okay, which of the following circuit elements will oppose the change in circuit current? No? So opposes the change in circuit current. Okay, so is it a capacitance, inductance, resistance, all, or all of the above? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter B, the inductance. Okay, so the capacitance will regulate or limit the voltage. No, yun yung pinaka-purpose lang because it stores energy. Therefore, if the source itself will be gone, no, nawala yung source, yung voltage will remain constant until the capacitor is fully discharged. No, yung resistance naman, no, so it does not oppose the change in current, ay ang ino-oppose lang talaga niya or ang kanyang ginagawa lang is to decrease, no, decrease the current flow or to limit the current flow, no, yun yung pinaka-purpose ng resistance. The inductance is the one who will oppose the change in current, because if the inductance fully establish its magnetic field, no, hindi na pwedeng baguhin yung current na pwedeng mag-flow doon, because the current on the inductance or in the inductor, as we know sa previous natin nga ano, na sa kanina na question, depends on the voltage across the inductor. So kapag nasa tamang value na yung current, so the current, any change in current or any addition on the supply or the current supply itself, it will never change, no, kasi nandun na yung ano na yung value ng electrical energy sa magnetic field ng ating inductance. Mababago lang yun if you are going to cut the supply from our inductor, no? So the correct answer is letter B. Okay, so I believe that will be all for this evening, no? So yan yung natin discussion natin, no, para sa gabi ito.